storm and they began to quiver and quake. And when that was happening, Peter began to wonder, where is the master? Where is the Rabboni? And then Jesus was walking on water. And so now, this is the third hour of the night. This is the third hour of the watch. Remember, God's day begins at night. It begins with darkness. It begins with gloominess. God is setting you apart and is pulling you out of systems. And as he's pulling you out of systems, he needs you to be an apostle in your own right, to be apostolic in nature, and to be a pioneer, and to trailblaze, and to break ground. And now you are going out of the employment area into the business area. It's so dark out there. You don't know what you want to eat tomorrow. You don't know how you want to pay your employees. But now it's so dark out there. God there begins in the dark, in the midnight, in the twilight, I mean. And in the twilight, Jesus was walking. And so now Jesus walked in the twilight. We got away in the twilight. Jesus did it on purpose. And it took over in the midnight hour, took over. And the third night, in the third hour of the watch, the star arose. In the third hour, in the third day, Jesus is walking. And as you see him, we think it's a ghost. We think it's a spook. Because I've never experienced something like this before. But I am telling you, he is not a spook. Just ask him to declare a word. Master, step on unto me. Tell me to come, and I shall come. When you hear the sound, the people that have been, the people that have seen, and they are calling you in the outer court, God, let us come. There is wine, there is water, there is corn, there is abundance in the enemy's camp. The enemy has been defeated. You need to align with your strength. And like Peter, step out of the boat and begin walking on the very words of God. There were three men in the boat. There were three men in the storm. It is Peter, it is Paul, and it is Jonah. Jonah was outside of the will of God, and the storm consumed him. He fell into the water, and the fish consumed him. He was outside of the will of God. That is Joel chapter 1. But now in Joel chapter 2, we are finding Paul, and Paul there is a storm. But in this storm, there is a Paul. But God is working in the calling of God. He is in the will of God, and he's not destroyed. He sat on an island, Malta, which has been prepared for us. I sent a storm. A storm blowing and raging, and in difficulty. But the Lord is saying, do not worry. I'm breaking your boat apart. But there is a Malta that I have prepared for you. There is an island in the midst of the storm, and I want you to go there. In the middle of, and then there was Peter. Now Peter was facing Jesus, and Jesus was the very will of God, and he silenced the storm. And so one was consumed by the storm, the other one survived the storm, but the other one silenced the storm. So the will of God is in motion, the divinity is in progress, divinity is working in us, the will of God is awake in us, he's leading us into all truth, he's leading us into all righteousness. We are commanding our storms to be still, we are commanding our storms to lay down on the ground. There is an awakening in Zion, he is blowing the trumpet, and he's doing this, it is happening at the third watch of the night. So what is this? In a day of resurrection, on resurrection morning, we hear about how many Magdalene arose in the twilight hour while it was still dark. She went to anoint him, but when she got there, she could not find him. And then a man appeared, who was Jesus, but she could not discern him. Do you know what she said? I say, where have they taken my master? The one said, Kikurio, and it means Lord. Master, it is greater than Rabboni. It is greater than Lord. She said, Kurio, where is my master? And for that awakening in the midnight hour, but when you awake in the twilight, you don't recognize him because you know him as Lord. You know him as Master. But he's arisen as Kurio. And she said, oh, Lord, where is my master? She could not discern him. So, oh, Zion, our awake. Awake in this thy season. Awake in this thy night. Awake with new strength. Awake with a new perspective. Awake with new courage. Begin to speak the things of God. Begin to be boldly proclaiming the words of the Lamb of the Lord in this our generation. Awake in the midnight hour. From this story we read and we understand that these people, while it was yet dead, they arose. And so now it will take for you to arise. Because if you don't arise, you find yourself in the book of Kings. And they will suck your baby in the midnight hour. Because the enemy, what they have done before, it is now dead. They do not sustain it for long. And so now in the midnight hour, the fresh wine is cut off. You need to awake because you will run away with the baby. But thanks be to God, she woke up just in time. But now it was too late. They were already swamped. But our wise man Solomon is arising. His name is Jesus. He has taken the sword and out of his mouth to sing the sword. And what is this sword? This sword is the word of righteousness. To sing from the lips of the master. And what is this sword? His divine soul from spirit. So we are moving from the flesh to the soul. Your heart. hear his voice. He's blowing his trumpet. Harden not your heart. We are the seventh day from Adam. No wonder Joel prophesied. The Lord prophesied. The Lord is coming with 10,000 of his saints. The seventh from Adam. We are the seventh from Adam. And we're an Enoch generation. A generation will be translated. And this generation is prophesying. What does Enoch mean? It means to equip. We are a generation which is equipped. And we are equipping our people. And we are saying the Lord is coming with 10,000 of his saints. And in that arising, Enoch is arising as a mighty man. He's the only one who pleased God. And in this time, Zion must awake in this perspective. Zion must understand that she is a people. And in this time, God is about to meet our every need. Like the leopard, there shall be so much provision. God has released a decree and shall give provision to each and every one of us. He's about to meet our need. We are tapping into super abundance. We are tapping into the day of Asher. What does Asher mean? Asher means happy. He shall yield royal dainties. There are royal dainties coming from Asher. So in the tribe of Asher, we are a tribe of prosperity. We are a tribe which is full of money. We are not calling money, no. We are commanding money to come forth from us. We are an abundant people. We are a prosperous people. You are Asher. You give us good new wealth. You are royal dainties. You are a people who are full of wine. You are a people who are prospering in every aspect of life. The Bible says in the book of John, "In I wish that you were in health, even as a spirit and body and soul prospers." We are the Asher company, and people who will prosper. Now you need to do it awake. Awake this new faith. It is not dark out there, but God's day begins in the night. And this day is not marked by chronological time. It's marked by the kairos of God. What is the kairos? It is a decisive moment. We have come to that decisive moment. The trumpet is blowing. This moment will change everything. This moment will alter history. There is a historic moment. This is the day of the Lord. And in the twinkling of an eye, in a moment, we have come to the moment of the Lord. And in this moment, we need to arise. Your moment has come. There was a season. There was a time at the pool of Bethesda where an angel came and stirred the waters. But now, only the first one who had touched the waters was healed. There was a man who was 37 years, but there was no man who could take him in there. But we did that one day. His moment came in that season. He did not even need an angel because his moment has come. He had to now lift up the bed. We can heal all this time. The Lord says, "Lift up all your burdens unto me. Lift up your problems unto me. Your moment has come." We have come to an opportune moment. Decisive moment, it will alter history, it will change everything. All we need to do is to arise in this dynamite, it is to go out in power, it is to go out in zeal. You must go and do these things and do not worry how all these things shall happen. Why? Because the zeal of the Lord of hosts shall perform it. Oh, Mary, do not worry, that holy thing shall be called child of the Holy Ghost. There is a baby in you living, is a child of the Holy Ghost. You are pregnant, you are his child. How shall it be? The zeal of the Lord shall bring it to life. The zeal of the Lord shall manifest it. Awake, O Zion, with new strength. This day is marked by the golden candlestick. It is like day and night with the golden candlestick. With the greed of men ever lighting it. The light of divine. And this light was a perpetual light. Yeah. It was to go on throughout all our generations. This is the day of the Lord. No man can ignite it. No man can take it off. But now the day has come. And the lampstand is shining. And the lampstand has no measurement. This day of the Lord cannot be measured by men. It cannot be contained by men. Who is this lampstand? His name is Jesus. He is the lampstand, the eternal one. Remember John chapter 6, I am the light of the world. He clothed himself with time, and by clothing himself with time, he manifested himself as the day of the Lord. Remember that the day, and this day is the perfect day. The Bible brighter. That shines brighter and brighter. But the light is shining brighter and brighter and brighter until the perfect day. This is the day of the Lord. It is the perfect day. And the sun is about to shine in its strength. The sun is about to shine in all its might. We have just entered into this new epoch. The Bible says, awake, O sleeper. Awake, thou that sleepest. Shake yourself from the ground. Awake and sit down. Because the Lord is upon thee. Awake, thou that sleepest. And Christ shall be a light unto thee. Arise and shine. For the light has come. And the glory of the Lord has risen upon thee. So the glory of the Lord has risen upon us. The day of the Lord, it has come upon us. It is like the lampstand. Remember, it is the day of the Lord. The lampstand has seven lamps. In a week, there are 7 days. But now, he is not entering into the rest on the seventh day. Having limited another day.
What is the horizon?
Now rally that place where you see heaven as touching. So, in the horizon, where heaven and earth meets, dwelling notion, in the horizon, Adam is awake. And again, that pain, and in the horizon, the light is touching. The hilltop. Who shall ascend the hill of the Lord? Then the light has upon the hilltop. But in the valley, there's darkness. Do not walk in the valley of the shadow of death. From the shadow of death. In the bed. But on the top of the hill, there is a light. So there's a breaking forth. There is a dwelling. Your tomb, the dwelling of the dead, is upon the hilltop. But the Lord dwelling, in that dwelling, Habakkuk chapter 3, verse 3. And out of his hand came out the horn. And in that horn was the hand of his power. But the word horn there is not a little horn. No. The word horn is a ray of light. So he said, out of him there is light for thee. In that light is the hand of his power. So in the dawn of the day, in the horizon, where heaven meets earth, at the very border of your age, at the very border of your faith, remember, the kingdom of God is at hand. What does that mean? The kingdom of God is in your reach. Jesus said, God healed the sick and said, the kingdom of God is at hand. When you receive healing, the kingdom is upon you. The kingdom of God is rushing with joy and peace in the Holy Ghost. He is touching on his hand. The kingdom is within your reach. And we are on the horizon. But in darkness. So notice on the veil, there's no light. You need to understand the hill. But the Bible says, we all are making a new way. Every valley shall be lifted up. The Lord is still on the valley. We have come to the valley of Eshkol. The valley of Eshkol. That is where Joshua came. The most gigantic cliffs and the most gigantic feet. This feet, the speaker, about peace and joy in the kingdom. And now the Lord and the mighty man, the Lord of hosts, we are God on this. He's squeezing grapes in the valley of Eshkol. He's squeezing them together. We are a battle of grapes. Remember, we are a grapevine. And as a battle of grapes, he's squeezing us together in the valley of Eshkol. And as he's squeezing us, there is no way to come. Shall become fruitful until the wilderness become a fruitful field. The fruitful field become a forest. And somehow they remain in the wilderness. Hey. We are the people of that way. In the valley of Eshkol, the Bible says, the valley of trouble shall be turned unto the door of hope. That's the book of Habakkuk. The book was there. Hey. The veil of trouble shall be turned into a door of hope. So in this calamity, in this desolation, God is opening a door of hope.
Yes, Lord.
And he's bringing a trumpet in Zion. And that trumpet is beckoning us. We are being beckoned by the fruit of the land. The figs of the land are beckoning us. We see the giants, but something is beckoning me.
Yes.
I see figs. They are beckoning me. I see a cake of a fig. You know what is the cake of a fig? I'll deviate. But there are cakes of the fig. I see the cake of the fig. I see the pomegranate. In the garden of the Shunammite, there were 10 fruits. Only one of them was local. It was the pomegranate. One of the pomegranate speak of? It speaks about the priesthood. The garment of the priest is a little pomegranate. The ephod of the high priest, it was blue. And then the little pomegranate. Blue speaks about heaven. So this is the priesthood which is touching heaven. And so now, by this priesthood, we shall bless people with the blessings of heaven above. And this is happening in the garden of the Shunammite. In that garden, there are many fields, there are many trees and fruit. But only one is local, get a pomegranate, and the other ones were imported fruit. What does it speak about? This other name fruit, it speaks about another nature in us, which is not of this world. This is the Spirit of God. This is the kingdom of God within us. In another nature altogether within us. We are giving out fruit which are not ours. So we need to cultivate the fruit of the Spirit. His personality is manifesting day in and day out in us. And without to release